Missy and Brandon Peters adore their new son, Lennox. It's just the lack of sleep that came with him that has them frazzled.
It's really challenging and a bit frustrating.
Most people think being a new parent means you're exhausted all the time, but it doesn't have to be that way. That's according to pediatrician Harvey Karp, who has helped millions of parents, including celebrities Michelle Pfeiffer, Pierce Brosnan, and Madonna. In his new book, The Happiest Baby Guide to Great Sleep, Dr. Karp clears up some myths passed down by many generations.
Should I try to be quiet so that way he doesn't wake up?
Myth number one, babies should sleep in silence.
It's actually one of the biggest misconceptions we have about babies. Everyone thinks you got to tiptoe around the baby sleeping, but actually in the womb, it's a very kind of a dynamic world for babies. And the sound inside is louder than a vacuum cleaner 24/7. So to bring a baby into a quiet room is actually weird for them.
So give your baby some white noise as loud as a shower, which as a bonus drowns out other household noise.
Is there a specific white noise that works best with babies and maybe makes them a bit more comfortable at night?
You want a rumbly sound, that's like a train or a plane, that kind of a sound that kind of puts you to sleep. And you play that all night long for the entire first year of life.
How can we lengthen the amount of time that he sleeps at night?
Myth number two, some babies sleep through the night.
You know how people say my baby sleeps all night long? Well, no baby sleeps all night long. Every baby wakes up 3 or 4 times a night. But you wouldn't know it if they're able to put themselves to sleep. If they can't put themselves to sleep, then they're calling for you 3 times.
So how do you teach a child to put himself back to sleep? Check out the next myth.
I usually nurse him right before bed, and sometimes, well, most of the time, he falls asleep in my arms. Should we just slip him into bed?
Myth number three, never wake a sleeping baby.
Nowadays, a lot of parents are told, don't let your baby fall asleep in your arms or at the breast, because if you slide him into bed asleep, he never really learns the skill of how to put himself to sleep in the middle of the night. And that's kind of true. But on the other hand, you can't keep a baby from falling asleep in your arms. And it's the most beautiful thing you ever do with your baby.
The good news is you can do both. Let your baby fall asleep in your arms and teach him to fall asleep on his own.
So when you slide him into bed, you wake him up a little bit. Which I know sounds like, you know, are you crazy? I would never do that. But here's the reason that you do it. You know, you feed him. You've got the white noise playing about as loud as a shower, and you've got him swaddled up. So when he wakes up, he's kind of drunk from the milk anyway.
Wake him up just a little with a gentle jiggle or a light scratch on the bottom of his foot.
Want his eyes open 5 or 10 seconds, because in that 10 seconds, he's going to start to learn how to put himself to sleep at night.
So by putting these myths to bed, baby and parents can sleep well. That way, everyone is happier and healthier. Lori Johnson, CBN News.